to the Augusta Coin Club's Spring Show, May 20th and 21st at the Columbia County Exhibition Center. Find all types of coins, collectibles, supplies, jewelry, and more. Admission is free, so bring the family to the Augusta Coin Club's Spring Show.
All the tools, the latest technology, and the largest team of five meteorologists. News 12, First Alert Weather, on your side. Closed captioning for News 12 is brought to you by Kenneth Nugent. From the station that's on your side, this is News 12, First at 5.
The nation's still reeling after a gunman kills 10 people at a New York grocery store. The violence hitting close to home for a Georgia activist originally from Buffalo.
And as a key Ukrainian city...
But first up, it's a hot one out there with a live look over downtown Augusta. And it's only going to get hotter as the week goes on.
Sending thanks to First Alert Chief Meteorologist Riley Hale. And Riley, you say that we are expecting some near record temps out there as the week goes on.
Yeah, guys, we're getting a nice, somewhat cooler afternoon today. We're staying away from the 90s, so this is going to be the coolest day for the rest of the week. Now, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we're expecting these to show the mid to even upper 90s some days, so it is going to get much hotter for us. Luckily, not much humidity today, generally sunny skies, mid to upper 80s across the area. Not finding any 90s so far, except for Fort Gordon. Fort Gordon did briefly hit 90 earlier this afternoon, currently at 89 degrees. Hey, folks, we actually got a new camera today. Really excited about this one. This is actually 750 feet up on our tower in Beach Island. So this gives us a really great vantage point all across the CSRA River region. Clear skies out there at the moment, so not much to see, luckily for us. Nice weather in store for this evening and tonight. We should hang on to clear skies. Calm winds, that means our temperatures are going to be able to drop fairly efficiently overnight. By tomorrow morning, we're expecting low temps down into the 50s, so a little bit below average for us to wake up to early Wednesday morning. We're going to wake up nice, mid to upper 50s across the region for the first part of our Wednesday. Later into the afternoon, though, we are expecting those 90s. High pressure is going to keep us pretty quiet. Not much rain in our forecast till this weekend. Talk about those hot highs and increasing storms for the weekend in just about 10 minutes.
Riley, thank you. President Biden traveling to Buffalo today, where he met with those families of victims from Saturday's shooting rampage, addressing the racism and hate that officials say motivated the gunman. Social media posts from the 18-year-old gunman revealing he'd been planning this attack for months. The president says the shooting is domestic terrorism.
The evil did come to Buffalo. It's come to all too many places. Manifested gunmen who massacred innocent people in the name of hateful and perverse ideology rooted in fear and racism.
And closer to home, an Atlanta activist originally from Buffalo says the community there is shattered.
Haley Mason shows us the effort she's taking to demand change and remember the lives lost.
It's all scary.
Portia Miller says she's devastated by the mass shooting in her hometown community, Buffalo, New York.
Everybody is just shattered right now.
Miller is an activist in Atlanta who grew up shopping at the top supermarket that was targeted by 18-year-old gunman Peyton Gendron. He identifies as a white supremacist. Police say he walked into the store and shot 13 people. 10 were killed. 11 of the victims were black.
This is my great aunt, May.
Miller showed us pictures of her great aunt who shops there weekly.
She is the one that always goes there and goes shopping and, you know, and pays her bills there.
She says her aunt just happened to sleep through her normal grocery store day on Saturday.
It could have easily been her. It could have easily been my cousin. He was there the day before. It could have easily been anybody in my family.
Across the country, the broader African-American community is reeling from another targeted mass killing rooted in racial hatred. The Buffalo shooter referencing the attacks on the AME church in Charleston as a part of his inspiration. Miller is organizing a prayer vigil in Atlanta, and she wants to push for legislative changes. The Georgia NAACP met with the FBI this afternoon. They're also calling for policy changes.
We've already been in contact with our senators and our elected representatives, both here in the state of Georgia and on the national level. So we are calling on legislative change. You know, thoughts and prayers are not enough.
We do not condone terrorism by white terrorists or terrorists of any color. Cannot be tolerated. We just don't want this to be just another incident that is normalized.
And there's a vigil sponsored by Just Georgia, which is led by NAACP and the Southern Center for Human Rights. And that is happening in just about half an hour in Decatur. Hunter Ukrainians are evacuated. Starting next school year, many teachers in South Carolina will now be guaranteed a break each day. Governor Henry McMaster just signed that change into law yesterday. It had been a priority bill for teachers this legislative session. State House reporter Mary Green spoke with educator groups today to find out what they think. At the start of this legislative session, leaders from both parties here at the State House listed education among their top priorities for this session. Teachers say they did pick up some wins in the last few months, but that there's still more work to be done, especially in the face of a worsening educator shortage.
If I look back on the 2022 legislative session, I'm hopeful that the story is that seeds were planted that will lead to more. But if this session alone is all that we get, then not enough was done.
Educator organizations say the passage of a bill to guarantee a daily half-hour break for elementary school and special education teachers is one of the major accomplishments of this year.
We heard from our teachers that going to the bathroom was a priority for them. They want to be able to take a break during the day and at least use the restroom. So the 30 minutes of unencumbered time is huge for us.
But other pushes fell short, including to expand scholarship stipends for college students majoring in education as a recruitment tool, and to give teachers more flexibility to get out of their contracts. Both groups say they can't fully grade this session yet because they're still waiting to see what comes out of the state budget, which should be finalized in the coming weeks. While both the House and the Senate have put more money toward public schools and raises for some teachers, the Senate's budget sets lower minimum salaries for teachers at every cell of the pay schedule.
That only guarantees a pay raise for teachers in 25 of our 77 districts. That's in a year where we have a record budget surplus, ponied with a record teacher shortage. It's just not acceptable to only provide raises in 25 out of 77 districts.
Both Kelly and East say that next year, more focus needs to be put on improving working conditions for teachers, like legislation that addresses growing class sizes. Reporting from the State House, I'm Mary Green.
And Kelly noted there are other bills passed this year that he says will help students and then indirectly benefit teachers. That includes one that bans school districts from hiring debt collection agencies to go after students who have lunch debt.
We have new video capturing the moment DeKalb County deputies catch people trying to bring contraband into the jail there. This all happening Sunday. The DeKalb County Sheriff's Office calls it their eye in the sky. It targets people who put contraband in bags that have been lowered to the jail grounds by inmates. Four people arrested in connection to this contraband drop, including two people already in that jail. Still ahead here, a mother furious after a student choked her son until he passed out at a South Carolina middle school. Coming up first at 5, how it all unfolded with the teacher in the classroom.
And 8 of our last 10 days have been technically below normal. We are going to be cranking up the heat and possibly flirting with record highs the next few days. On that full forecast next.
Time lines. Every summer it gets hot and humid. We wonder what a dry heat might feel like, but we're kind of feeling that right now.
Yeah, all I feel is heat, Riley.
We've been really lucky so far this year. We haven't really had a real taste of our summer humidity, but the heat is definitely going to be found across the area in the next couple of days. So far today, we have avoided the 90s, but we've been up to 87 so far in Augusta, so technically just a degree above average, but we'll call it seasonal this afternoon. Low humidity, lots of sunshine, beautiful weather on tap through this evening and tonight as well. That heat is going to be found starting tomorrow. 94 degrees is what we're going with for a high on Wednesday. If we do hit 94, that would be our new hottest day so far of 2022. I don't think it's going to last long, though, because Thursday is going to be even hotter. Thursday into Friday, we're expecting upper 90s, and I think we actually have a good chance of actually breaking the record high temperature on Thursday, possibly tying the record on Friday. So with that forecasted high of 98 Thursday, that would break the previous record of 96 set back in 1996, and we got a good shot of tying that record on Friday as well. So this is going to be some pretty intense heat, even for May standards. One thing we also have to start worrying about this time of year is the UV index. So that is going to be running in the very high category Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Once we do see the UV index get this high, that's when you need to start taking a little bit extra precaution. If you can help it, just try to avoid those peak UV hours between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. That's when the sun angle is highest and when you have the most risk to be impacted by these UV rays. So just try to protect yourself from the sun. It's not going to be improving anytime soon. Going to stay in that very high category through most of the summer. High pressure is in place. It's going to keep our rain chances pretty slim the next couple of days. But as we head into the weekend, we are going to start to notice an approaching cold front, and our winds are going to be turning back out of the south-southwest, and this is going to bring us back a little bit more moisture. So starting Saturday afternoon, we'll likely start to track at least the chance for some scattered thunderstorms. Those will be moving in along the sea breeze, heading inland towards us as we head towards sunset. And then the cold front's going to be a little bit closer by Sunday, so better rain chances by Sunday afternoon. And unfortunately, this front doesn't completely die or get south of us, so it's going to keep our rain chances in play both Monday and Tuesday of next week. So just a heads up, we are going to see that pattern flip once we move past the weekend. Or once we move into the weekend, excuse me. But no rain in the forecast for Wednesday. Thursday night, there are some models showing the potential maybe for a stray shower. Looks to be very limited, though. Not really expecting better rain chances until we get to Saturday, Sunday, and early next week as well. This is the current view from our new tower cam. This is at Beach Island. You can actually see some of our TV towers here in the shot. So this is 750 feet up in the sky. So this is actually giving us the highest vantage point over the area out of all of our cameras. So this is going to be really cool once we do start to see some storms popping up across the area. We are at 87 degrees right now if you are stepping out soon. Once we move past sunset, temps will stay in the 70s and 60s through midnight. But by tomorrow morning, we are expecting below average low temps, mid-50s for places like Bushfield for the first part of our Wednesday. Later into the afternoon, we're hitting the 90s, so about a 40-degree temperature swing tomorrow. Going to stick with the heat at least through Friday, but a little bit cooler for the weekend as those storm changes do go back up.
Thanks a lot, Riley. A middle school student in North Charleston facing second-degree assault charges, and a teacher there is on administrative leave.
As Nick Reagan reports, it all comes after a video surfaced on social media showing a student choking another kid until he passed out.
Oh, he did! He did.
This video, taken on Monday at Deer Park Middle School, shows the moments a 13-year-old boy was choked until he lost consciousness.
How can these kids be laughing and joking and thinking it's okay that another student possibly killed another kid?
All of this in front of a teacher. In fact, you can hear students talking to that teacher.
I can't see real life.
The teacher should have stepped in as soon as he seen what was going on.
School administrators alerted North Charleston police after the video was sent to the school principal by a parent later that day.
The teacher let him get back up in his seat and continued on his schoolwork instead of sending him to the nurse or the principal.
The student did see a doctor and was diagnosed with a concussion. He still has these bruises. The teacher has been placed on paid administrative leave while the school district investigates the incident. But the images will forever be seared into Calder's memory.
It keeps replaying over and over in my head because whenever they zoomed in on his face and everything, I could see the fear in his face, and he told me he was scared for his life.
The suspect has been charged with second-degree assault. When questioned by a school administrator, the police report says the student replied that he was, quote, just playing.
Well, it's elevated above playing now. Calder says she's pressing charges against the suspect, the teacher, and the child recording the incident. The school district says they're investigating that video as well.
Well, how old were you when you opened a bank account? Some Georgia kindergartners are getting a head start on savings. We'll show you how after the break.
8/7 Central on CBS.
Well, as Riley just mentioned, temperatures are climbing, set to reach near record highs in the upper 90s this week. That's the hottest it's been all year.
Yeah, I decided today that I'm not ready.
Not quite.
It's not comfortable.
We don't need to rush into summer.
But First Alert Chief Meteorologist Riley Hill shows us how it'll impact our everyday lives.
Yeah, guys, now that it is starting to heat up across the area, we do need to start paying attention to the heat and how it does impact kind of some of our everyday activities. So once those air temps start to get above 90, that's when we can actually start to see some dangerous temps on these surfaces. So especially asphalt, concrete, we can see these temperatures get up to 125 and even seeing asphalt get over 140 degrees at times. So pay attention to this if you're going to be walking your dogs. Ideally, you want to walk your dog on grass or just a shaded area. If you do walk them on concrete or asphalt, it can actually burn their paws fairly easily. The best way to test this is use the back of your hand. If you can put the back of your hand on this surface and leave it for 7 seconds, then you're good to go. If you can't, though, then that surface is too hot to walk your dog on. Also, we got to worry about hot car dust. This is a concern every single year. We average about 38 hot car deaths per year in the U.S. And this can happen with air temps as low as 73 degrees. So that's when you can actually see the temp inside the car get over 100 within just about a 30-minute period. Now, say the air temp does get up to, say, 90, then we're looking at way hotter temperatures inside that vehicle over a very short amount of time. So last year, we actually had 23 fatalities due to hot car deaths and 25 in 2020. These numbers are actually much lower than our average year to year. So this is actually showing improvement. But remember, just always check that back seat. And also this time of year, it's a time of year where you have to worry about heat exhaustion, heat stroke as well. Luckily, we're not seeing a lot of humidity with this heat, but just know the symptoms. If you start feeling that throbbing headache, no sweating, that's a big sign of a heat stroke. You do need medical attention very quickly. Heat exhaustion, just a little bit different. You can feel faint, dizzy. You can have some excessive sweat, but each one just kind of leads to a nauseous feeling. So if you start to feel any of these in the heat this week, definitely seek medical attention. We'll have another look at that forecast towards the end of the show.
Leaders in Georgia say it's never too soon for kids to start learning about saving money. Here's something they're trying in Atlanta. The mayor announced a new savings program for public school kindergartners. It gives each kindergartner a savings account with $50 in it. The program encourages students and parents to keep that account growing by adding more money as the years go by.
I put my money in a piggy bank. My parents put my money in a savings account so it can grow bigger and bigger and bigger.
Oh, how cute is she? The students will also take financial literacy classes through their years in school. They can't withdraw the money until the student graduates.
Every foster child, their forever home.
And we continue our partnership with Grant Me Hope today by introducing you to a Georgia girl who wants to be a rapper or a vet.
Madison is looking for a family who can give her support, encouragement, and most importantly, love.
My name is Madison. I'm 15 years old. I like pets because they can't argue with you. They might bark a lot, but like you could actually vent to a dog, and I like doing that because they have opinions, but like you don't understand them, so you can get all your emotions out. I like expressing my emotions and feelings through art. I like to draw whenever I can't read. If I get bored, I just turn to books. Any book. I'm not very needy. I just focus on myself and what I have to do. My favorite class is definitely not math, but any other class I'm cool with. If I have something to do, I'll do it. Other than that, I just like read a book till I fall asleep after I take a shower. I want to be a rapper or a vet. I've always been inspired by different rappers to make the world a better place. Take Tupac. He's always wanted to like change the world and become a better person, while other rappers are just rapping about drugs and things like that. Foster care system, you're just going from place to place and like different lifestyles, different roles, and it gets very confusing. Adoption is supposed to be a happy feeling. For me, I want to be adopted because I feel like once I am, I'll feel like I belong more. I'll have somebody to call, my mom and my dad. I feel like every child who's in foster care should have a chance to be adopted. I'm looking up for a forever home, so I feel like I belong more.
Grant Me Hope, because every child deserves a loving home.
You could tell she has a very sweet heart. A love for books is going to take her far, no matter what.
Yeah, bright future ahead of her. She just needs a forever family. And if you want to learn more about Madison, you can head to our website, WRDW.com.
Or check out the app for more ways to help kids just like her through our partnership with Grammy Hope.
And we are back with our latest winner for our Sunshade giveaway. A big congratulations to Miss Doretha Roberts from Hepzibah, Georgia. If you would like your very own Plunkett Heegan Air Sunshade, just go to WRDW.com. You can click on contest, enter your email, and we'll announce those winners right here at first at 5 every Tuesday and Thursday. Now look at that 7-day forecast just after the break.
I'm experts for over 40 years. Your car is totaled. Let's have a conversation.
Our to take a look at our three-day forecast. We are expecting those hot highs to be increasing for us. 94 Wednesday, 98 on Thursday, 97 on Friday. Not much rain in our forecast the next 3 days, but as we head into the weekend, that's when we will start to notice a pattern shift for us. Both afternoon, Saturday, and Sunday, we'll have at least the risk for some scattered thunderstorms. So if you do have weekend plans, try to get them in earlier in the day. That rain will be timed out after lunchtime.
All right, thanks for that, Riley. Still to come, a patient dies at the Charlie Norwood VA, and the Federal Inspector General identifies failings in their care. We break it down when First at Five continues.